How many in this class have heard of a gang? How many know of a gang member? Maybe in their neighborhood or around? How many in this class know of a gang hand sign? Okay, show me a gang hand sign.
Parents should watch for certain behaviors that may indicate that their child is becoming interested in or involved with a gang.
I think parents should be well aware that if their children are showing signs of disrespect, a change in attitude, are they staying out late at night, are they being real secretive, are they wearing a certain color all the time, are they wearing a certain set of beads all the time, when they're bringing their notebooks home, are they being secretive with their notebooks? Because today, our society, we have MySpace, YouTube, we have the internet. These young people can get information readily available quickly. We have to say, I need to take notice of this, and I need to address this with my child. I need to talk to them about, why are we writing this?
A young person might develop a sudden interest in music, videos, or movies that glorify gang behavior. Other signs to watch for involve clothing and symbols drawn on their notebooks, withdrawing from family members, declining school attendance or performance, confrontational behavior such as talking back, verbal abuse, name-calling, and disrespect for parental authority, sudden negative opinions about law enforcement or adults in positions of authority, signs of drug or alcohol use, tattoos with names, initials, or symbols, guns or ammunition or other weapons, physical injuries, unexpected cash or possessions, such as clothes or jewelry, and a change in attitude towards school, church, or other normal activities.
I went through court with my mother and father, battling with my kids. She didn't want her grandkids raised around drugs and gangs because she thought it was no life.
Family members play an important part in the battle against gangs. In addition to watching for signs of gang involvement in their young people, family members can take proactive steps to help their children make the best choices for their future and avoid getting trapped in a gang. Tell your young people that you disapprove of gangs. You don't want to see your young people hurt or arrested. You see them as special and worth protecting. You want to help with their problems. Find out about your children's friends and their families. Find out about local services, nonprofit as well as government, that can help fight gangs. In addition to police programs and church outreaches, look into community athletic programs, Boys and Girls Clubs, the YMCA, YWCA, Boy Scouts and Girl Scouts, drug abuse prevention groups, and community centers. There are plenty of things that family members can do in their community to fight gangs. It just takes determination and the willingness to get involved. Children naturally look to adults to figure out how to behave. That means their parents and caregivers have a tremendous opportunity to influence the behavior of young people by being a person with self-esteem, compassion, and good character.
Remember that you're the most important role model your child has. If you need help, try finding a mentor for your child, someone who's interested in the same things that he or she's interested in, and someone who will care for them and help them through those difficult years of adolescence.
I tell parents that, what if I snitch on my child? And I use that word snitch because that's what they use. And I tell parents, hard love, you have to show them. Because a young adult who's gang related, they're gonna try and test you and test you until you're wore out to the point where you give up. I tell parents, never give up. If you gotta show hard love, show it. But you have to stay involved. You have to show that child that you're not going to intimidate me. Your gang's not going to intimidate me. If I have to get law enforcement involved, if I have to get social services involved, the courts involved, I'm going to stay the course. And I recommend to parents, stay with it, stay through the course, and by all means, fight the war, or you're giving your child away. Later in life, that child's going to thank you.
Gang involvement often leads to being arrested and winding up in the juvenile detention center or jail.
Here in the jail, you got people that still want to come home to a gang. I just come from the penitentiary not long ago. You still got people that's trying to join the gang, but I tell them, yo, that shit, it ain't what it is to join no gang, though. I wouldn't recommend nobody to join no gang.
Won't nobody from the gang there for me. Won't nobody pick no money up for me for no bond or no lawyer. It was just that and me being in here this time. Me just having a sight and my family just opened my eyes clear to make it look that, to make so I can see that it's not just about being in the game, because life is more bigger than just being in the game, because all you're doing is dying for a color.
I ain't long term. All that colors of this person driving this car, that person driving this car, that all lead to one thing. You being locked up and you ain't never been able to come home seeing your family, seeing somebody who you love.
You don't never know when you're going to die or whenever, because you might got robber gangs or your people in your own gang that might try to pick hits out on you. To tell my younger brother anything, I would tell him that gang banging ain't a lifestyle, it's a death style.
Gangs are a threat to all of us. While young people are often the victims of gang violence, gang-related crime affects the entire Norfolk community.
I recommend, especially for parents of young people, to get involved in their children's lives. Don't be afraid to ask questions. Don't be afraid to find out who they're hanging out with at home and at school. Be proactive. Don't wait until something happens before you find out what's going on in your child's life. Become a part of your community. Join the Civic League. Doesn't take a lot of time, doesn't take a lot of money, but it lets you know what goes on in your community. And find out and let your children know that you care what they do. Keep in touch with people in your community so you can know what's going on and what's happening around you.
Facing gangs can seem like a daunting challenge, but it is one we cannot afford to ignore, because the price for not facing gangs isn't just more of the problems they cause in our community. It is the very lives of our young people.
Too many families are the victims of gang violence. It's time to get involved, and the time is now. First thing I want you to do is turn off your TV and start talking to your kids about gangs.